So now we discussed when given two points x1, y1, z1 and x2, y2, z2, the line which is passing through these two points, those direction cosines is always x2 minus x1 by root over x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square plus z2 minus z1 whole square. Next, y2 minus y1 upon under root x2 minus x1 the whole square plus y2 minus y1 the whole square plus z2 minus z1 the whole square. Next, z2 minus z1 upon under root x2 minus x1 the whole square plus y2 minus y1 the whole square plus z2 minus z1 the whole square. So these are the formula to calculate direction cosines when given two points. Similarly, we know the direction ratios when given two points. We have to know that direction ratios when given two points. Direction ratios also we have a formula x2 minus x1, y2 minus y1, z2 minus z1. This is the formula we have to use. Direction ratios passing through two points or when given two points direction ratios. We can use this is also x1 minus x2 and y1 minus y2 and z1 minus z2. It is also we can helpful to use direction ratios, right? Next, the important point is if suppose the line is not passing through origin, the line is not passing through origin, not passing through origin, then how to calculate direction cosines? For that, what we have to take? Simple, ra. So now you can take the coordinate system, x, y, z. They are given, one line is here, AB. What are the direction ratios or direction cosines or distance between these two points? What we have to do? This is a line in the space. Next, you have to draw one more line which is passing through origin and parallel to the given line. So, draw one line passing through origin which is parallel to AB. These inclinations you know very well. It is making with x-axis alpha, beta, as well as gamma. Similarly, these direction angles are also equal to this. Why? Because if two lines are parallel, then their inclinations are same. So, let draw a line passing through origin and parallel to given line. Hence, direction ratios of PQ is equal to direction angles of PQ is equal to direction angles of PQ is equal to direction angles of AB. Hence, DCs of AB is equal to DCs of PQ. So these two are equal. So next one important point is if two lines are parallel, then their direction ratios or direction numbers equal or proportional. This is very, very important one. You have to remember. If two lines are parallel, obviously their direction ratios or direction numbers may be equal or may be proportional. If three points are collinear, three points are collinear, then direction ratios of three points ABC are collinear. Hence, DRs of AB, DRs of BC, DRs of AC, any two must proportional. This is very, very important. They will ask for PUC as in two marks question. They will give 3 points, ask them to collinear. Next, hence we have to do direction ratios of AB or BC, AB or AC. Then we have to prove their direction ratios are proportional or equal. Next, if two lines are parallel, then their direction cosines are equal. These are direction cosines, don't confuse. These are direction ratios. Direction ratios may be equal or proportional, but direction cosines must be equal. That's why if you take a line L, if you take a line L, or if you take any 2 points on the line L, AB, always direction cosines of AB is equal to direction cosines of L. So don't confuse that. They are asking direction cosines of AB, or they will ask direction cosines of L, means if you know the 2 points, you can calculate direction cosines for this. It is also the direction cosines of line L. Similarly, the direction ratios of this is also equal to or proportional to the direction cosines of that. So based on this concept, we will go through the exercise 11.1. So 11.1, they will ask for only 1 mark or 2 marks questions. The first question is, if the line makes an angles 90 degree, 135 degree, 45 degree with the coordinate axis respectively, x, y, z, find the direction cosines, find out. So here given ra inclinations, angles is nothing but inclination. Let we will consider that alpha 90 degree, beta 135 degree, and gamma 45 degree. You know that direction cosines that we are denoted with L, M, N, R, cos alpha, cos beta, cos gamma. So now we considered L is equal to cos alpha. We know the alpha value here. Alpha value is given 90 degree. So cos 90 is 0. Next, M is equal to cos beta. Beta angle is given here 135 degree. Substitute in beta place is 135. So we can split into in terms of complementary angle. 90 plus 45, it is in second quadrant. Minus sine 45 you will get. Minus sine 45 is minus 1 by root 2. Next, N is equal to cos gamma. So we know the cos gamma angle is 45 degree. Cos 45 is 1 by root 2. Therefore, direction cosines, that is equal to L, M, N, which is equal to 0, minus 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2. So these are the direction cosines of the given problem. Next one, second problem. This is important. Find the direction cosines of a line which makes equal angles equal angles with a coordinate axis. Coordinate axis. So, you know that coordinate axis means in the space XYZ system. So, we can take as X, Y, Z and horizon. There is given one line. Let it be considered. This is a line OP. It makes equal angle with coordinate axis. Usually, this line is making an angle with x-axis is alpha, y-axis is beta, and z-axis is gamma. That's we know very well. They told in this problem, alpha, beta, gamma are equal. That is the meaning of equi-angles. So now, given that alpha is equal to beta is equal to gamma, apply cos apply, then you will get cos alpha is equal to cos beta is equal to cos gamma. We know the relation between cos alpha, cos beta, cos gamma. What is the relation? Cos square alpha plus cos square beta plus cos square gamma is equal to 1. So cos square alpha place is cos square alpha only. But cos beta value is nothing but cos alpha. So instead of cos square beta, we can write as cos square alpha. Similarly, cos gamma value is also cos alpha equal. So we can write instead of cos square gamma is cos square alpha, which is equal to 1. So cos square alpha is in 3 times. We can write 3 cos square alpha is equal to 1. Cos square alpha is equal to 1 by 3. Cos alpha is equal to plus or minus 1 by root 3. Now, already we know that cos alpha, cos beta, cos gamma are equal. That is nothing but plus or minus 1 by root 3. So therefore, they are asking find the direction cosines of that line. So write it, direction cosines is denoted with cos alpha, cos beta, cos gamma. So its values are given as plus or minus 1 by root 3 comma 1 by root 3 and 1 by root 3. So this is the required answer. So the next problem is if the line has the direction ratios minus 18, 12, minus 4, then what are the direction cosines? So here direction ratios are given. Given that DRs, direction ratios. What are those? Minus 18, 12 and minus 4. Usually direction ratios are denoted with ABC. A is equal to minus 18, B is equal to 12, C is equal to minus 4. So we have here, remember it, when given DRs, ABC values, there is a relation between direction cosines. What is that relation? A by root over A square plus B square plus C square plus or minus. This is L value. Next, plus or minus B by root over A square plus B square plus C square, which is equal to M, plus or minus C by root over A square plus B square plus C square, which is equal to N. So L, M, N are called direction cosines. When given direction ratios, we have to calculate direction cosines. We should apply these formulae. So you remember it. Direction cosines, L, M, N, which is equal to, your formula is plus or minus A by root over A square plus B square plus C square, plus or minus B by root over A square plus B square plus C square, plus or minus C by root over A square plus B square plus C square. So we know the ABC values, let's calculate it. L is equal to plus or minus A by root over A square plus B square plus C square. So plus or minus A value is given minus 18 upon under root A square, 18 square, 324, B square, 12 square, 144, minus 4 whole square, 16. So plus or minus minus 18 upon root over, we can add, you will get 484, plus or minus minus 18 upon root over 484 is 22. We can cancel it, 2 9s are 2 11s are. So this is the L value. Now we have to calculate M value. Plus or minus B by root over A square plus B square plus C square, that is equal to plus or minus B value is given 12 upon the same denominator is 324 plus 144 plus 16, which is equal to plus or minus 12 upon root over 484, which is equal to plus or minus 12 upon 22. We can cancel it. You will get 6 by 11. Next one is N, which is equal to plus or minus C by root over A square plus B square plus C square. So plus or minus, what is the C value given in the problem? Minus 4 upon root over 324 plus 144 plus 16, which is equal to plus or minus minus 4 upon root over 484, that is equal to plus or minus minus 4 upon 22, which is equal to plus or minus minus 2 by 11. So we have to write here finally direction cosines. Direction cosines is equal to LMN, which is equal to plus or minus is in outsider. We got the L value is here minus 9 by 11. M value is 6 by 11. And N value is minus 2 by 11, which is a required answer.
Students,
next fourth problem, it is also important for 2 marks.
Here given 3 points,
2, 3, 4, minus 1, minus 2, 1, 5, 8, 7. We have to prove that they are collinear. Just now I told, whenever they are giving 3 points, you can see that the given 3 points lie on the same line, we will say that they are collinear.
In three-dimensional geometry, how to prove the given points are collinear?
Just you have to calculate direction ratios of AB, direction ratios of BC, direction ratios of AC. Any two, either AB, BC, or AB, AC. You can see that these direction ratios are equal or proportional, then we can say that the given 3 points are collinear. So, consider 3 points are ABC. Let A 2 comma 3 comma 4. B is given minus 1 minus 2 1. And C is given 5 8 7. Now, we have to calculate DRs of any two. That is your wish. Direction ratios of AB. You know that when given 2 points, how to calculate direction ratios? 2 points are given, direction ratios formula, x2 minus x1, y2 minus y1, z2 minus z1. I told you can use this formula, or otherwise x1 minus x2, y1 minus y2, z1 minus z2. Your wish, you can use any one of the formula, either this or this. Suppose I am applying this formula, direction ratios of AB, you know that A value here 2, 3, 4, and B value is also given that minus 1, minus 2, 1. Now DRs of AB, DRs of AB, so X2 minus X1, minus 1, minus 2, Y2 minus Y1, minus 2, minus 3, Z2 minus Z1, 1 minus 4. You can simplify it. You will get minus 1 minus 2 is minus 3, minus 5 and minus 3. These are the DRs of AB, which is equal to direction ratios of AB. Now, we have to calculate direction ratios of either BC or AC. Let I am calculating AC. DRs of AC, direction ratios of AC. So you know that same formula we have to apply here also. X2 minus X1, y2 minus y1 and z2 minus z1. Now A is given as 2, 3, 4, B is given as minus 1, minus 2, 1. Sorry, you have to take as AC, not AB. C is equal to 5, 8, 7. We will apply the same formula, drs of AC. X2 minus X1, 5 minus 2, Y2 minus Y1, 8 minus 3, Z2 minus Z1, 7 minus 4. If you simplify, you will get the answer, 5 minus 2 is 3, 8 minus 5, 8 minus 3 is 5, 7 minus 4 is 3. Now, these are the DRs of AC, these are the DRs of AB. You can see that these two are in proportion. What is meant by proportion? Nothing but their ratios must be one constant. For example, you can see that minus 3 by 3, corresponding components are minus 5 by 5 and minus 3 by 3, which is equal to minus 1. If you divide this minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, we are getting some constant. By this, we can say that direction ratios of AB and direction ratios of AC are proportional. Proportional. Hence, ABC are collinear. So, this is the required answer. Next problem, we have the fifth one. Find the direction cosines of the sides of a triangle whose vertices are 3, 5, minus 4, minus 1, 1, 2, and minus 5, minus 5, minus 2. Here given three vertices of a triangle. We have to calculate sides of a triangle, direction cosines of sides of a triangle. So consider, let A 3, 5, minus 4, B minus 1, 1, 2, and C minus 5, minus 5, minus 2 are the sides of a triangle, vertices of a triangle. Hence, what are the sides? AB, BC, and AC are be the sides of a triangle. Sides of a triangle. So, you know that A point and B point, B point and C point, A point and C point. If you know two points, we can calculate the direction cosines. So, what is that formula? Now, first we are going to calculate direction cosines of, they are asking side. First side is I am taking as AB. Direction cosines of AB, when given A and B, the formula is x2 minus x1 by AB, y2 minus y1 by AB, and z2 minus z1 by AB. Once again, you remember it. When given two sides, we have to calculate the direction cosines. x2 minus x1, that particular side magnitude. y2 minus y1, that particular side magnitude. z2 minus z1, that particular side magnitude. First, you can see in the problem, they are given A as well as B. So, A equal to 3, 5, minus 4, and B is equal to minus 1, 1, 2. x1, y1, z1, x2, y2, z2. And also, we need AB distance. What is the distance between AB? You know the formula, x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square plus z2 minus z1 whole square. x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square plus z2 minus z1 whole square. Apply the values here. x2 minus x1 minus 1 minus 3 whole square. y2 minus y1 whole square. 1 minus pi the whole square, z2 minus z1 whole square, 2 plus 4 the whole square. If you simplify, you will get minus 4, 16, 16 plus 36, which is equal to root over 68, which is equal to root over 4 into 17. We can write 2 root 17. This is the AB magnitude or AB length. Now, we can substitute here. X2 minus X1, minus 1, minus 3, upon AB magnitude, we got AB magnitude is 2 root 17, comma, Y2 minus Y1, you can see here, X2 minus X1 means minus 1, minus 3, upon 2 root 17, Y2 minus Y1, 1 minus 5, upon 2 root 17, next Z2 minus Z1, 2 minus half minus 4, nothing but 2 plus 4 by 2 root 17. You can simplify, you will get minus 4 by 2 root 17, minus 4 by 2 root 17, and 6 by 2 root 17. After simplification, you will get minus 2 by root 17, minus 2 by root 17, and 3 by root 17. So now, direction cosines of AB is equal to minus 2 by root 17, minus 2 by root 17, and 3 by root 17. So we got the side AB. Next we have to calculate side BC. Direction cosines of BC. Same formula we have to apply, which is X2 minus X1. But now you have to amplitude of magnitude of BC. Next, Y2 minus Y1 upon BC, Z2 minus Z1 upon BC. So this is the formula, direction cosines of BC. You know that B as well as C. What is B here? Minus 1, 1, 2, and C is given minus 5, minus 5, minus 2. We need to calculate BC magnitude. BC magnitude, same formula, X2 minus X1 the whole square plus Y2 minus Y1 the whole square plus Z2 minus Z1 the whole square. So you can simplify, you will get 16 plus 36 plus 16, which is equal to root over 68, which is equal to root over 4 into 17, that is equal to 2 root 17. So we got the magnitude of BC. Now, direction cosines of BC, you can apply in that formula, X2 minus X1, X2 minus X1, minus 5 plus 1, upon BC, BC magnitude we got root over 17. Next, Y2 minus Y1, Y2 minus Y1, minus 5 minus 1 upon 2 root 17. Next, Z2 minus Z1, this is Z2 and this is Z1, minus 2 minus 2 upon 2 root 17. You can simplify this, you will get the answer. This is minus 4 by 2, minus 4 by 2 root 17, minus 6 by 2 root 17, minus 4 by 2 root 17. After further simplification, you will get as minus 2 by root 17, minus 3 by root 17, and minus 2 by root 17, which is equal to direction cosines of BC. Therefore, direction cosines of BC is equal to minus 2 by root 17, minus 3 by root 17, minus 2 by root 17. So we completed two sides, AB as well as BC. Next we will calculate it as AC. Students, we completed AB side direction cosines, BC side direction cosines. Now we have to calculate direction cosines of AC, RCA. The same formula we have to apply, X2 minus X1 by magnitude of CA, Y2 minus Y1 by magnitude of CA, and Z2 minus Z1 by magnitude of CA. You know that C value as well as A value, minus 5, minus 5, minus 2 is point C, and A equal to 3, 5, minus 4. Now we have to calculate magnitude of CA. X2 minus X1 the whole square plus Y2 minus Y1 the whole square plus Z2 minus Z1 the whole square. You know the distance formula. Is it clear? Right. 8 square 64. This is 100 and this is 4. So totally we will get as root over 168. This we can split as 4 into 42, which is equal to 2 root 42. This is the magnitude of CA. Now, direction cosines of CA formula. Direction cosines of CA. X2 minus X1. X2 minus X1. 3 minus of minus means 3 plus 5 by magnitude of CA we got 2 root 42. Y2 minus Y1. 5 minus of minus 5. 5 plus 5 by magnitude of CA. Next Z2 minus Z1. Minus 4 plus 2 upon 2 root 42. After simplifying, you will get as 8 by 2 root 42, 10 by 2 root 42, and minus 2 by 2 root 42. Now, we have to simplify 4 by root 42, and 5 by root 42, and minus 1 by root 42. So, we got the direction cosines of A, B, B, C, C, A. These are the sides of a triangle. So we'll complete the exercise 11.1. Now we will go through the lines and planes. In three-dimensional geometry is divided into two parts, lines as well as in planes. We learned in the first PU lines in the plane. Now we are going to learn lines in the space. So they are divided into two parts. Now we are learning the line in the space. Line in the space are lines in the space. So we have here four important theorems are there. One theorem you will get as in 5 marks. What is the first theorem? Theorem one. They will ask the question in the PU examination like derive the equation of a line in the space which is passing through given point A, and parallel to a given vector, both vector and Cartesian form. This is the theorem they will give in the examination. Once again, you can remember. Derive the equation of a line in the space passing through a given point and parallel to a given vector. So now they will give one point and one parallel vector. We have to calculate the equation of a line. So this theorem is very, very important. Diagram is mandatory. Without a diagram, you won't get the marks. Compulsory diagram irbekri. You have to draw neatly. So this is a x-axis, y-axis, and z-axis. This is an origin O. Now we have to calculate equation of one line L. This line is passing through one point A. This is a point A, whose position vector, whose point is x1, y1, and z1, and parallel to a vector b bar.
equation of a line passing through a point parallel to a vector.
So this point you can connect with origin. Let it has some position vector a bar, and consider one general point on this line. General point or arbitrary point or variable point. This is x, y, z. This point, it can be movable on this line. You can consider anywhere. This point P, you can take anywhere. This is a fixed point. It cannot be fixed. It is a variable point or general point or arbitrary point. So that point coordinates, just we are assuming that x, y, z. Connect with that point is also in origin. This position vector we are taken as R bar. Now, before it is a line, it has only direction, no magnitude. When I am taking two points on this line, now this is a vector. Why? Because it has a direction and two endpoints. This vector is lie on this line. So this line is parallel to this vector. This line is also parallel to vector. This AP bar is also parallel to this vector. Why? Because this AP bar is coincide with line L. Obviously, AP bar is parallel to B bar. That we are going to take here the condition. Now, first we have to write what are the points we are consider there. So let L be the line. L be the line passing through the point. Passing through the point A of x1, y1, z1, whose position vector A bar and parallel to B bar. This is the first point. Once again, let L be the line passing through the given point A, x1, y1, z1, whose position vector is A bar and parallel to B bar. Second point, let P be the x, y, z. P be the x, y, z. Any point on the line. This point we will take as a general point or arbitrary point on the line L, whose position vector R bar. Now we know that from this diagram AP bar is parallel to B bar. So now we are proving the vector form. AP bar is parallel to B bar. We know the in vectors, if two vectors are parallel, A bar is parallel to B bar. We learned in the vectors, A bar is equal to lambda times of B bar, or B bar is equal to lambda times of A bar. We can use this condition. So here AP bar is parallel to B bar. I can write that is AP bar is equal to lambda times of B bar. What is lambda? Lambda is some real number. Lambda belongs to R. Next, AP bar position vectors OP bar minus OA bar, which is equal to lambda times of B bar. OP bar position vector in the diagram is R bar. OA bar position vector in the diagram is A bar, which is equal to lambda B bar. Therefore, R bar is equal to A bar plus lambda times of B bar, where lambda is belongs to a real number. This is called vector form of a line. This is called vector form of a line. So we completed vector form. They are asking in the question both vector and Cartesian form. So the line is having both vector form and Cartesian form. Now we have to calculate the Cartesian form. Cartesian form. Cartesian means consider these values in the vector notation. They are given in the points. So R bar. R bar is a position vector of P. What is the point P here? X, Y, Z. Let OP bar R bar is equal to XI cap YJ cap plus ZK cap. Point conversion into vector formula. Next, A bar. A bar is the position vector of point A. Point A, we assumed that X1, Y1, Z1. So, let OP, OA bar is equal to A bar, which is equal to X1 I cap plus Y1 J cap plus Z1 K cap. The next one is we have lambda. Lambda becomes a real number, need not to take here. Next, B bar. B bar is a one parallel vector. So, let B bar is equal to AI plus BJ plus CK. What are ABC? A comma B comma C are direction cosines of, direction ratios of B bar. These are direction ratios of B bar. So B bar always we will take AI plus BJ plus CK. Substitute these values in the form R bar is equal to A bar plus lambda times of B bar. R bar value is given here, left side XI plus YJ plus ZK cap. A bar is given X1I cap plus Y1J cap plus Z1K cap plus lambda times of B bar. What is B bar here? AI plus BJ plus CK. Now we have to go through simplification. After simplifying, this vector will bring into the left side. It becomes minus. This vector minus this vector. You know that if two vectors addition, subtraction between the corresponding components. Corresponding component means I component, J component and K component. So I can write like this. X minus X1 into I cap. Y minus Y1 into J cap. Plus Z minus Z1 into K cap. Which is equal to this vector already left side we subtracted. Right side we have only this value, should multiply with lambda. So lambda is a number, it can be multiplied each and every value. Lambda A I cap plus B lambda J cap plus C lambda K cap.